just another song. Sing a song.
Whoops.
Oh, you recognized me.
Gentlemen, what shall we do with this spy?
I am not a spy. I am an innocent foot cutter. Have you seen a little girl wearing a red cape carrying a basket of goodies on her way to Grandma's house?
Gentlemen, what shall we do with him?
Throw him in the river!
Oh, no! First we'll give him a fair trial, then we'll throw him in the river! Prisoner at the bar, how do you plead?
I am innocent!
Innocent? You were caught red-handed!
I repeat, I am innocent! My lips are sealed. Tis a far, far better thing I do. Long live the fatherland! Long live Carlsberg! Long live the king! Long live Lips!
Oh, stop! Gentlemen, what's the verdict?
Guilty!
My friends, follow me. There's a wedding party up the river at the White Swan Inn. We haven't been invited, but I'm sure they'd love to have us.
Asterberg is right. What's another 40 or 50 guests at a family affair?
Oh, one gentleman!
Catherine. Karl Franz has monopolized you long enough. May I have the pleasure of escorting you tonight?
Of course, Doctor. I'd be delighted.
Very well, Doctor, but it means a duel.
Agreed. I make it sword at 10 paces.
Shall we, Doctor?
If you don't mind, could we wait for just a moment? A beautiful night, eh, Kathy?
Oh, yes.
Tell me, do the stars shine as brightly as these in Vienna?
Vienna?
It is your home, is it not?
Yes, it is.
They tell me you're going back there to marry your cousin.
Oh, I'll probably go home one of these days soon. There are enough old maids in the world as it is. After all, I can't stay in Heidelberg forever, can I?
No one can stay in Heidelberg forever.
Thank you, Doctor. You have a good heart.
Not too good lately. I'm afraid it's been missing a few too many beats. Shall we?
You go ahead, Doctor. I'll join you in a moment. Please.
Gesundheit!
Oh, thank you. Now, where was I? why?
My heroism under duress was astounding.
Oh, yes. My heroism under duress was astounding. I fought off 40 of the ruffians, overpowering them with fantastic strength and agility. But eventually, sheer weight of numbers overwhelmed me. But never fear, Your Excellency. My lips were sealed. They got nothing from lips! I was thrown into the raging torrent!
Excuse me, sir, but don't you think that's exaggerating, sir? The river is only 4 feet deep.
A river can rage at any depth. 4 times I sank to the bottom, 3 times I rose to the top. And then in one magnificent effort, I leaped onto the riverbank. And holding the scoundrels at bay, I made my escape. But at a great cost to my health, Your Excellency. Put those in. I fear I shall never recover from this ordeal. Don't you think a month on the Riviera would be justified? Or if not a vacation, at least a medal. And a small bonus. Forever ready to serve the fatherland without reward, I remain your obedient servant, Rich!
Oh, sir, a modest and unassuming letter.
A lifelong failing, Hubert.
Yes, sir. Tootsies.
Oh! Oh, no, 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 no.
Here, put this in dry dock.
Your clothes are drying by the fire, Hareless.
Oh, thank you, my dear.
Thank you.
Here, drink this.
Oh. What is it?
My mother's old-fashioned cold remedy. Schnapps, beer, wine, gin, and brandy mixed over a hot flame.
I'd like to meet your mother someday. God, you're beautiful.
God, you're drunk.
Shall we dance, my gorgeous one? Come! Saving for a special occasion. The special occasion is now.
Count Meltzer, I fear you are a most wicked and depraved man.
Thank you. Champagne, Your Grace.
Oh.
To you.
No, no, no. To you.
Oh. Now tell me, Your Grace, how did you know that I would be alone?
I didn't.
I wasn't.
Where is His Highness?
His Highness, always studying. Books, books, books.
How interesting. Well, I'm delighted to hear it. After all, he is going to be in the family.
Who? Yes, of course. And when is the happy event to eventuate?
Oh, very soon. And then I shall take my rightful place on the throne. With Carl Franz, Daphne, of course.
Three on the throne. Sounds crowded.
Well, Rubova, it's the ideal arrangement. Suppose the king is indisposed, the queen is out of town. Let no one say that royalty would let the people down. If there should be a crisis or a panic in the realm, who always will be ready to stand steady at the helm? Her Grace, Serene, the mother of the Queen, I'm much more influential than it is generally seen, which may explain why only those who are insane would dare complain. My place in court is utterly unique. My word is law in Spanish or in Russian, French, or Greek.
Fancy then, they pay attention when they hear you speak.
I feel the honors I receive are merited. My daughter's charm is there for everyone to see.
And her perfection is, of course, inherited.
That's not the half of what she got from me. The truth, I feel, is rather widely known. Whenever people talk about the power behind the throne, it's me they mean, the mother of the queen. The banners wave, the horses prance, the men take up their arms, the bayonets are gleaming, and the bugles sound alarms. Our enemies surround us, and disaster is at hand. When threat of war is in the air, who's there to take command?
Who?
Her Grace, the mother of the Queen. My post is most important. If you gather what I mean, then people find, if they disturb my peace of mind, my will is grim. We hear about the mistresses of kings, through their wit and charm accomplish such surprising things. But I'm the one to make a ruler run around in rings. A man of Pompadour can meet her Waterloo, but she is lucky if she doesn't lose her head. It's so much better just to have a doctor who is smart enough to share the royal bed. When men report the annals of the court, in years to come they'll have to say, "Oh, I saw him they held a court." To show the world how many ways it pays to be like me.
I'll fetch another bottle.
I'll be waiting.
Goody.
Oh,
asked you to wait in the carriage.
I'm bored to death waiting. Oh, champagne for two. Was she pretty?
Who?
The lady called from hesitating.
Nothing of the sort, dear. Remember now, the last time Carl Brown saw you, you were just a child.
I may come as an awful shock.
Nonsense. You will come as a delightful surprise, which is why we're here. I want him to see what he's getting.
Mama, you're amazing. You never miss a trick.
Her Grace, the Grand Duchess Anina of Cilicia.
Grace, your grace.
A group of dedicated scholars.
I must apologize, Your Grace. You see, we were celebrating Dr. Engel's appointment to a chair as Professor of History.
Oh, professor! A history of schnapps through the ages?
I can see that we're only feeding the way here. Your Highness, Your Graceness, this.
Gentlemen, Heidelberg seems to be a very lively place.
The what? Who?
Forgive me, cousin. I'm afraid I shouldn't be here at all.
Cousin?
Yes, dear boy. This is your betrothed, Stephanie.
Stephanie? A great honor, cousin.
How well you look, Barbara.
Thank you, Your Grace.
Oh, never mind the formalities. You are to call me Mama, I insist. I insist!
Mama.
Stephanie, kiss Carl Franz.
I trust I find you in good health, cousin.
Thank you. I am well, cousin. I trust I find you in good health.
Thank you. I am well.
Oh, please. Please, you both sound like a medical report. Now remember, you're engaged to be married.
Champagne, Your Grace! Champagne!
Lutz, what's going on here?
Lutz, Your Highness?
My valet, Your Grace.
Valet? Count Meltzer? Von Mark, I'll kill you!
Your Highness, may I be excused,
please? You may go to the devil!
Thank you!
Mama, hadn't we better go?
Yes. We must go. Stephanie, you may kiss your cousin goodbye.
Yep. Mm-hmm. Goodbye, cousin.
Goodbye, cousin.
My dear prince, you have a lot to learn if you expect to continue the royal line of Carlsberg.
They're not going to trap me. I won't let them. I'm never going back. Never! Kathy! Kathy!
Your Highness, what are you doing?
Doctor. Stay out of this. I don't want you to get into trouble on my account. You know nothing, understand? Nothing!
What is it, Carfrance?
Kathy, how would you like to go away?
Go away?
Yes, forever!
What are you talking about?
I'm talking about us! Let's run away to Paris.
Paris?
Yes! It's simple. We get on the train tonight, and then tomorrow we'll be there. Just think of it!
I can't think of it. Carfrance, you're crazy.
Of course I am! That's the whole idea! Kathy, do you love me?
Oh, my darling.
Now, Put on your new dress, the one that I like so much, and then get packed. Just a few things. We'll buy you a real wardrobe in Paris, where dresses were born.
Oh, I adore you. Oh, but what will your grandfather say? Oh, what will the Prime Minister say?
They'll be furious, but I can't help that. I've my own life to live, and we start right now. Come on.
Of us alone, there will be no chaperone to supervise us. In Paris, our behavior, so I heard, and we ought to be observed, and no one will say a word to criticize us. I know where all the smartest people go there. We'll show them with the invites you so divinely in Paris. True lovers find there that love is kind there, so there we'll stay. I'll buy you a chapeau.
What's that?
A hat. You'll have the whole true soul.
That His Majesty, your grandfather, is very ill.
Grandfather ill?
You are needed in Carlsberg. It is vital that you return there at once. I have instructed Lutz to pack your things. There's a train in half an hour.
I'm not going with you.
Your Highness!
I won't! I can't! I'm not going back to that prison! I'm not going to live that lonely life again!
Did you stop to think how lonely your grandfather must be at this moment?
Of course I thought of my grandfather, but I can't...
May I remind you of the consequences of what you're doing?
It is pointless to discuss this any further!
Your Highness! Your Highness, I've known you your entire life. You have all the qualities necessary to be a true king. Your personal feelings cannot enter into it. You are Carlsberg.
What can I do, Doctor?
His Excellency is right, Karl Franz. We always knew this day would come. But perhaps it will only be for a short while. I'm sure His Majesty will recover, and you'll be back here to finish out your year.
Very well, Your Excellency. I'll be ready. No, Doctor, you have your own work to do here. And besides, I need you to look after Captain. Will you do that for me?
Of course, Colonel Franz.
Look, Colonel Franz, the train's scheduled for Paris, and... What is it?
Kathy, my grandfather's ill. I must go back to Karlsruhe.
Me?
Just for a little while, a week, perhaps two at the most, but I'll come back, I promise. You understand, Kathy, don't you?
Of course I do. You must go. Look at this, covered with dust. You're a fine one. All your things would be ruined if someone didn't look after you. That Lutz is a big help, I must say.
Youth, music,
and no king. Where is His Majesty Lutz?
Well, the last time I saw him, he was taking a quiet stroll in the garden. He often does that to calm his nerves before an ordeal.
Ordeal? What ordeal? He's announcing his marriage to the Princess Stephanie tonight.
Well, that's what I had in mind.
Don't worry.
Yes, Excellency.
Your Grace. Where is who, Your Grace?
You know perfectly well who.
Oh, you mean His Majesty. Yes, well, I was just waiting for him myself. He'll be along any moment now.
Now look, Von Mark. When we marry His Majesty, there will be some changes made.
Changes, Your Grace?
Yes. His Majesty's intrigue in Heidelberg with a little barmaid.
That is completely forgotten.
Not by me. There will be no royal mistress in this marriage. We have never had them in my family.
Your Grace, I'm certain the Grand Duke wouldn't have dared. Music! Shall we return to the ballroom? Will you dance the gamut with me?
If I must.
Princess Stephanie Augusta Teresa of Silesia.
Your Highness, welcome to Carlsberg.
Thank you, Your Excellency.
May I present His Excellency Henri Lebeau from the court of Louis de Bouillon.
Enchanté, Your Highness. You are charmant, the most beautiful of princesses.
Quel compliment, monsieur. Je suis bien sûr que je ne mérite pas.
And His Excellency, Don Alfredo de Segonzec, the Spanish ambassador.
We trust Your Highness will visit us in Madrid.
Gracias, Don Alfredo. Por mucho tiempo he deseado visitar la bella España.
El daughter del mío!
Gentlemen, please, I should love to dance with all of you. But it can be only for a moment. You see, my card is filled for a lifetime.
St. Jerome on the first day of October this year of grace.
My dear boy, may you both be as happy as I am at this very moment.
Thank you, Your Grace. Mama.
And I feel as though I'm not losing a daughter, but gaining a king! Son.
That's most gracefully, cousin.
Thank you, cousin.
And I do hope as you live among us here in Carlsberg, you will grow to love our country as we do.
I know I shall.
We will do our utmost to see that you are very happy, cousin.
Trust I may do as much for you, Carlfrost. Yes, it all went quite well, didn't it?
The princess looked her very best. A fortunate choice, Your Majesty. Her Highness will make a truly lovely queen.
I'm sure she will. Tell me, Von Mark, how did you know so many years ago that she would turn out so well?
I was convinced that the princess took after her father.
I am fortunate to have you at my side.
Thank you, Your Majesty. Your Majesty, I know how difficult these past few months have been for you, especially since the passing of Dr. England.
I miss him, Von Mark. More than I can say. But at least he ended his days as he wished, at Heidelberg.
Your Majesty, if at times I have seemed too demanding, it is only because of my loyalty to the House of Carlsberg.
I know, my friend. I know.
And may I add, how truly proud I am that our country has a king such as you.
Thank you.
And now, may I withdraw, Your Majesty? Oh, Your Majesty, by the way, there is an old man who wants to see you. The guards have sent him away several times, but he keeps returning.
Now, who is he?
I have no idea, but he says that you once promised him a position.
Send him in.
Very well, Your Majesty. Good night.
An old man who promised.
Your Majesty.
Herr Ruder? Ruder! My dear old friend! Oh! It's so good to see you!
Thank you, Your Majesty. I was afraid you wouldn't remember.
Oh, wouldn't remember? Of course I remember. Oh, Ruder, here, have some wine. I remember how much you like this. I made you a promise, didn't I? Tell me, Ruder, have I changed much?
Of course, Your Majesty.
I have. How?
Well, at Heidelberg, you look like a boy.
And now?
Now. You look like a kid.
A lot happens in a couple of months. Tell me, Ruder, do they miss me?
Miss you, Your Majesty? Well, you know how it is at the university. The boys come and they go. One group leaves, the other arrives.
All the faces look the same. I know, but truly some are the same. My friends, Von Asterberg.
He is a model student. Now.
And Lucas and Detlef.
Yes, Detlef is engaged to be married.
Oh,
and Lucas. Well, he is still Lucas.
Hey, who's living in my room?
Well,
have there been many duels lately? Does the Saxon court still meet at the inn?
At the inn it is just as it was.
Oh, and your niece.
Who?
Your niece, Kathy.
Yeah, is she still there too?
She hasn't married.
No. But she changed. She used to be such a happy girl, and now I often find her crying.
Very well, my friend. Let's see that you get some supper. We'll find a place for you to sleep, and then tomorrow you'll begin to learn your new duties as wine steward.
Oh, thank you. Thank you, Your Majesty.
Go with this gentleman. He'll take good care of you.
You are still the same, Count Franz. Even though you're a king now, you're still the same kind and loving boy.
So lonely. Everything in my life has become meaningless. My old friend reminding me how much I've lost. It's as though the past were reaching out, trying to speak to me.
I have memories haunting me so.
Remember what you told me, Doctor. It will be the best time of your life. Treasure it.
Golden days in the sunshine of our happy youth. Golden days full of innocence and full of truth. Every hour, every moment held a new surprise. Golden days when our hearts grew wide.
Deadlift! Lucas! Astrobar!
To the end, we're marching for the throne. Marching where the trees are marching, we go. Down the lane we're singing, and our voices singing, and the air flows beating, and we're rousing in. We are celebrating every fascinating little girl who's waiting for us at the end. Come to Lord,
wait,
sing a song.
Don't go! Don't go!
May your days be cloudless.
Kathy!
May your nights be sweet. here. Her name is Kathy, I believe. Yes, ma'am, what can I do for you? I don't know you, do I? I just wanted to meet you. You're very pretty. I'm afraid I don't understand. I've come to see you because I hear you're a friend of the man I'm going to marry. You're the Princess Stephanie. I don't know why I'm here. It seemed like a good idea. It seemed if I saw you. But how does it help? It doesn't change things, does it? I mean, kings aren't supposed to love the women they marry. They just marry them because they have to. Why should I care? I'm not supposed to love him either. But you're the one he loves. I am so sorry.
You think Karl Franz loves me? Is that it?
It's funny. I thought he loved me too. Oh, it was such a wonderful time. It was almost like a dream. When he was called back to Carlsberg, he promised he'd write. Every day, he said. And he didn't. Not a single letter. I should have realized it wasn't anything. He was a prince, and I was nobody. Oh, it was spring, and he was young, and he thought. But now it's autumn. I was a fool to be. You're still in love with him, aren't you?
His Majesty is visiting old Hawkins, taking a sentimental stroll by the riverbank. Most moving. Even I am moved.
Oh, you are actually moved, Lord.
Of course he is. Look, there's a tear in the corner of his eye. Oh. Is it possible you have fallen in love with Heidelberg?
What? Fallen in love with this miserable town, the dampness of the river, the provincial food, and oh, good God, it's true! I have fallen in love with Heidelberg. I may even start singing. Oh,
gentlemen, if His Majesty is really coming, we must prepare an official welcome.
Yes, yes. I can write a speech.
No.
Well, at least we have our own welcome song to sing.
No, gentlemen, please, His Majesty requests no speeches, no songs, nothing of the sort. Just behave quite naturally. However, not too naturally. After all, he is the king now.
What? Oh,
Gretchen, how you must have missed me. Come into my arms.
Why?
I am about to permit you to embrace me.
You mean you don't know?
Know what?
I'm no longer a barmaid.
Then what are you?
I'm an heiress. My aunt died.
Oh.
And left me 12,000 a year.
Oh. 12,000? Darling, I adore you.
I'm no longer available. I'm engaged.
You are engaged?
Yes. And my fiancé insists that I retire. We intend to do nothing but travel. Dear Hubert.
Hubert? Hubert!
Did someone call? Lutz! Nice to see you again.
Oh, boy.
Young Gretchen, we must pack.
We're off on the grand tour, finishing up Bon Bon. Do drop in on us if you're in the neighborhood. We'll be taking the baths.
I hope they drown!
I took it on the bridge and looked.
12,000 only goes to prove one should never lower social barriers.
Gentlemen, His Majesty the King.
No, gentlemen, please, could I trouble one of you for a stein of beer?
A stein for His Majesty.
Lucas.
His Majesty.
Netlet, Astaberg. Oh, please, let's sit down. Sit down. Gentlemen, to friendship.
To friendship.
Thank you, Your Majesty. Goodbye.
Kathy, please!